resistance, a way of resistance that is done of daily action, daily challenges, daily relationship in the network, in the context, in relation with the local people and with other people, also trying to solve daily conflicts that may arise in this in experience like this of resistance.
So the first room that you see here, the greeny blue one, mm-hmm. It's a hosting and orientation, let's say, office for women, which is a generic term to say that. First, it's an information desk, we could say, and is involved. It's called Margarita, that we will meet right now. And this other collaboration, other ladies making the same activity, working with her. They also sometimes have some kinds of laboratories or workshops or sessions to learn, to share the experience. And once a month, they organize also some kind of artisanal market here. Each week they have the assembly, so once a week they decide what do we have to do, what do we have to decide, who does what, and what do we need to do, how do we collect money for this thing, etc.
Memoria indifferente dura.
Memoria indifferente is the name of the performance. Indifferent memories, and it's a performance of 1 hour in which he presents ten portraits, 10 ladies. He tells the story of each one, and at the end of each story, he reveals the portrait of each one of them. I have met 10 partigiani. Presenting myself like I was, who I am, normal person, artist, writing, design. And I've met and listened to this story, and there was this sharing experience together. Also, a lot of memory and testimonies goes away also. And this is also each time a tragic moment, because a strong testimony and history and disappears, and his work was to try and block and maintain some elements and testimonies of these ladies.
La vera resta lì un po' incerta. Non capisce perché dovrei ringraziarla per una cosa che hanno fatto tanto tempo fa. Le donne che vi racconto questa sera sono persone semplici. Probabilmente non ammetteranno mai che ciò che hanno fatto è stato straordinario, ma secondo me hanno saputo ribaltare il mondo e per fortuna l'hanno fatto per il verso giusto.
Potrei scrivere un romanzo della mia vita, ma ora non ne ho più voglia. Ci sono cose che a ricordarle si sta male e ci sono cose che ti fanno sentire orgogliosa. Ma poi il tempo cancella, anche. Avevo iniziato a scrivere, ma poi da qualche parte deve esserci, in casa.
Quando mio padre, dopo la caduta di Mussolini e dopo l'8 settembre, ha cominciato ad aiutare quelli che scappavano e quindi a costruire in concreto la resistenza, io, pur essendo figlia di gente poverissima, io andavo già in bicicletta 20 km andare, 20 a tornare. E quindi ho chiesto di aiutare mio padre che già era nel comitato di liberazione.
How do they feel now? Because they already have fought Nazism and they managed to win, but now
non si studia abbastanza, non si conosce abbastanza la nostra Costituzione, che è bellissima.
Devo premettere che siamo entrati in clandestinità, nel senso che ognuno faceva un piccolo compito e non sapeva praticamente quello che faceva l'altro. Ognuno agiva dietro un impedimento del momento. Questa era cominciata così la resistenza in Italia.
I bring home a lot of information and emotions about the Second World War that I wasn't aware of, and it was a fantastic opportunity to meet people who were actually there, and they felt and experienced it in their own way, and especially these ladies, these old ladies, and I feel a lot of sympathy and respect towards them. So I'm really glad that I could join this project.
Thank you.
I think I gained a lot of knowledge concerning the topic, and I gained a lot of experiences because I was part of the team who was kind of coordinating.
Not mine, you were doing this. Attend seminars thanks to you.
Okay. So for me it was a very important thing. So, yeah. Thank you.